Hey, what's up, guys? This is Ultimate Dave Live here. We're gonna be doing some reaction videos, obviously, alongside our gaming stuff. I kind of want to branch out and do some other stuff as well. So today we're gonna be reacting to a song by Tool called Vicarious. Now, I'm a big rock fan, as most people know. I enjoy all kinds of music, though, first and foremost. So we'll be doing a little bit of everything, but you know, I've listened to a few songs by Tool, 46 and 2. Schism, Anima, Sober being the main ones. Today we're gonna listen to one I haven't listened to and just see, you know, how it feels, and if I dig it or not, or parts I really like. I was a musician, disclaimer, so there are some things like I'm gonna talk about as far as you know, grooves and stuff like that that some people may not understand. I'll try to explain as best I can as we go. But I'm really excited, guys. This is my first reaction video. So we're going to jump into the song. So here we go, guys. All right, it's got that nice Tool feel as we're starting here. Almost sounds a little bit like Schism in parts here, I can tell. I like that. The nice thing about Tool is they don't do anything in 4-4 tempo, or at least not very often anyway. This is one of those songs where it's just got a really fat bass groove that just kind of drives the song, it seems like, so. I was a drummer, but I can still appreciate good music grooves as much as the next person. Ooh, I like that drop. Oh, man. Why haven't I listened to this song before? Holy hell, I'm digging it. Liking the drum beat here. Oh yeah, I'm digging it. I gotta get a feel for it. It's the first time I've heard this song, so it's like, I gotta get used to that drum beat really well. Bring this down just a smidge. Alright, so honest to God, that is just fantastic. I've been needing some good rock music in my life. I like how the guitar's not even driving this part. It's just pure bass. Guitar comes back in very, very elegantly. I like that nice little touch. The thing I like about Tool and a lot of this progressive rock style is it really takes you on a journey. It's not just the same kind of level across. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how you can tell it's good writing, is when you got, you know, instead of it being nice and even all the way across and flat, it takes you on a journey through the ups and the downs, and, you know, you feel as these things change, and that's when you know it's good music. I'm digging this. Ooh, I like this little breakdown right here. I don't think it's quite a bridge section, but it's really, really nice. I like it. Oh man, that's dope! This is also technical. Like, I can't even begin to go into all the details as far as like how they put their music together, but Tool just does such a fantastic job of the technical aspects of music. Oh man. Yes, dude. Yeah, You know it's a good song when you start air guitaring and, like, geeking out, dude. I love it. I love it. A lot of people say some of Tool's music sounds the same from song to song. I can kind of see that, but honestly, like, I just like it enough. I don't give a shit. It's so good, dude. It's so good. And that's not, don't get me wrong, not all of Tool's songs are the exact same cookie cutter. It's not. Not even close. There's so many levels of intricacy in this that I can't begin, you know, like I said, to describe it all. But what I will say is if the formula works, don't break it. And Tool does it so perfectly, man. One thing I wish with Tool music, and I know a lot of people will agree, on YouTube will agree with this, is they wish it was on Spotify, another form, so they could stream it more. I understand why it's not, though. And, you know, that I agree with Tool. I think music needs to, the value of music needs to be raised again, you know. I mean, streaming services are so popular and downloading music is such a thing, but honestly, I like Tool's mentality, old school mentality, man. I love actually owning the physical album. I own so many physical albums, you know, in my house that I think that's the only way to know and love and appreciate music really is to own it. But, you know, I do stream music, so I can't say that too. I'm a bit of a hypocrite, but, you know, I try to own the physical albums of artists as much as I can. By the way, chat, let me know what you guys think of this song. Also, let me know down below if there's another song you want me to react to. If we get a popular one that keeps coming up and keeps coming up, I will definitely react to it. Also, feel free to like, share, subscribe, and comment, you know, anything you might want to see in the future. And here's where Tool does such a good job, from the songs I've heard, of starting to re-escalate back to that high point again. They bring you all the way down, let it settle, and kind of simmer. And I know I'm making a cooking analogy here, but, you know, I like cooking too. So don't fucking judge me. But they do a good job of simmering and then bringing it back up again, dude. It's just like, when it hits, you know it's starting to come back up. And I can see it building now. But, dude, this is wicked. There's the title. They bring it in the last 30 seconds of the song. Holy cow. This is a long song, chat. Like, it's a 7-minute song. But you get so invested in it, dude, you don't even know that it's that long. It doesn't feel 7 minutes long. Tool songs don't ever really feel that long, you know? They don't hit that point where you're like, okay, I'm done, I'm over this song. They just have that nice groove that keeps you going. You're like, all right, I can get behind that. So yeah, guys, that was Vicarious by Tool. Like I said, we'll be doing some more reaction videos here in the very near future. Maybe some TV shows as well. We're not going to do any more reaction videos this week because I uploaded my end of the year highlights video on Twitch as well, which you can find on my channel. Also, guys, be sure to, like I said, again, like, share, subscribe the content if you enjoyed it. Leave a comment down below what song you'd like to see next, maybe as well as a TV show you'd like to see me react to. I'm taking suggestions on that as well. Have a good day, everybody, and have a happy and safe New Year's. If you're going anywhere, don't drink and drive. Find a designated driver. I love you guys. Be safe. Have a fantastic rest of your New Year's Eve, and have a very happy New Year's. We'll see you next time.